Reclaiming your spiritual heritage, your covenant blessings, beloved. Did you know that tithing was so powerful? And that God has given us the tithe to break generational curses and redeem us by returning to Him? Before we left yesterday, I said, why is it that some people tithe, but yet their heart did not return to God? Because they are keeping rules and regulation. They are not tithing out of love and consecration to God. Some people are giving even to the Lord just to get. But when they see somebody in need, according to the scriptures, they have no heart to give. See, these are people trying to play the number. Your heart is not really with the Lord. You are giving Him. You didn't return to Him. You just saw in the scriptures that giving will bring a blessing. So you start giving, but you don't love Him. Your heart has not come back. He says, return unto me. He didn't say return to the tithe. You tithing is the first evidence of your return or your heart's return to the Lord. So return unto me, and I will return unto you. And he said that the tithe is how you begin. So just giving money and all of that stuff. And these things I'm mentioning give you away. Because you're a tither and you're sowing seeds in church and all of that stuff. But somebody needs a dollar, $2. You can't give them. You won't entertain strangers unawares. In other words, you are not listening to the Lord. You are keeping rules and regulations. Somebody needs a ride, you give them a ride, but you're going to collect $5 or $10 from them. How have you helped them? Your heart hasn't come back to the Lord. You're just playing the money game. That's what has happened to the church. So many people refuse to tithe and say it's Old Testament and say, one guy wrote me, calling me names on the internet and said that those that tithed in the Bible, it's a few of them, but it was not commanded. I say, is this a command or is this an issue of heart and love? As I will show later on, Abraham gave tithes to Melchizedek. He wasn't commanded. It was a testament that God was the one that gave me this mighty victory. It's all a heart thing. I don't know what people are talking about. The blessing is so amazing in my life that I don't have time to debate theology and legalities with ignorant people, because I know those of you that are in those camps, you have no evidence of God's approval. So why will I waste time with you? I want to use the time your broke self. Come on, return to the Lord like we all have. And then He will return to you and break curses from you and deliver you from all the gains that Satan has made in your life. It's not a money thing, beloved. It's a heart thing. Return unto me, and I will return unto you. He said, wherein shall we return? He said, will a man rob God? Think about it. Let me dwell on that for the rest of today. Will a man rob God? God said to me, when a man gives a tithe to me, he has not given me anything. I said, really? He said, yes, because it's not yours. He said, it's mine. He said, I won't call you a thief if it was yours and it's your discretion whether to give it or not give it. This has nothing to do with Old or New Testament. He says, you're a thief. I've asked people, would you go into business with a thief? Would you make a covenant with a thief? Beloved, you are living beneath your privileges, and the tenth that God has asked you to give that you refuse to give is impoverishing you, because whatever curses in society and all the mess going on will be on your doorstep. The money you're handling, do you know how many sick people touched it with infectious diseases and all of that? But God says if the first fruit be holy, I believe in the book of Romans, then the lump is also holy. We give Him the tenth to sanctify the 90 and free it from every curse running in society. It's a blessing. It's a miracle. I can just hang out here because this is my heart. This is what I understand. And I just want the people of God to enter into the reality, the fullness, the blessing. Don't tithe religiously. Don't tithe legalistically. Don't keep the rules. Let your heart come with your money. Hallelujah. He says it's not yours to keep. That's why it says, will a man rob God? It's because it's not yours. It's not your discretion. It belongs to the Lord. That is your covenant entrance. That's why you begin to return for all he has done for you, for the salvation you've received and he paid for in the blood of his son, for the heritage that is yours. How can you argue with that? Whoop! No pastor has anything to do with this. No church has anything to do with this. Stop running from your covenant responsibilities that will purchase to you a good degree, a great heritage, and a great life, and a great covenant. It's such an amazing blessing that the church is being denied because we don't understand that this is heart and not rules and regulation. So you have robbed me. But you say, wherein have we robbed thee? In tithes. But watch this. Then offerings. An offering is a gratitude from the heart. A thank you. I'm saying, Lord, I recognize that you have blessed me. You have helped me. It's a thank you. He showed me that the offering of thanksgiving is how you seal everything God has done for you. That's how the blessing becomes permanent. What I'm saying then is so critical, and I really don't have time to do justice to it. But I will just emphasize that. Maybe I pick it up tomorrow. I'm not in any rush. I'm just going to hang out here and just open my treasures and keep talking to you so that God will deliver you from doing the right thing and not getting the blessing because you're doing it legalistically, religiously, and covetously. The Bible says, through covetousness, they will make merchandise of you. Don't give just to get. Give to God. It's a heart. Return to the Lord. Then the offerings will come forth. Then the blessing will become permanent. You see, I see people, whenever you give testimony, Satan will attack the thing and we're soaking the testimony in the blood of Jesus and all this. No, bring an offering to say thank you. And your blessing will become permanent. God will forgive you. God will bless you. God will get the curse out of you. We love you. We thank God that you are listening and you haven't turned us off because this is those touchy areas. That's what we need in these last days. Amen and amen. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. The Lord is waiting.